And we had a surprise yesterday. I got a call from Mr. Craig Miller, who's from the Orlando area, and he said, you know, I'd like to come by and to one of your REC meetings. And I said, well, we have our P5 caucus, and we have some other things planned tomorrow. But I said, if you'd like to, thinking that nobody in their right mind would want to come the very next day, when you invite them to say, to come on down to address everybody, he jumped at the fact and said, I'd be more than happy to come, not only to one of your meetings, but I'll come tomorrow night. And I said, well, it's a great time. I said, we'd love to have you. He's the newest candidate into the race. He's the former CEO of Ruth Chris Steakhouse. I mean, everybody likes, I'll tell you, you haven't placed it by heart yet, by stomach, because and you can tell I'm a little bit bigger guy, so I really like the steaks at Ruth Chris. But it's Craig is a proven conservative leader. He's done a lot for the Republican cause in Orlando, both as an activist and a former candidate. And we're lucky to have him here with us today. Let's give a big assertion of welcome to U.S.
Anybody that would like to see Senator Bill Nelson retired in 2012, please stand up. Please stand up. Please stand up. Anybody in the room, please stand. Anybody in the room that would like to see President Obama repealed and sent back to Illinois, put your hands together and let's clap. And what my new friend Frank said is, you'll never get a standing ovation from this group of people. And I said, Frank, you watch, okay? Now what that is a demonstration of leadership. What it also is a demonstration of what we don't have in Washington. We have such an absence of leadership and leaders in our nation's capital that our entire country and our entire future is now in jeopardy. Not only in the United States Senate, but we have people like Speaker Pelosi and others in the Congress that need to go back to where they came from and give back our country to people like us. My name is Craig Miller, and everything I say, I approve. I'm a candidate for the United States Senate. I went from the dish room to the boardroom, and I want to go to the United States Senate and represent you. I started at 13 years old. I've had my hands in more hot water than most women in this room. And I'm proud of it. I've created over 40,000 jobs in my career. I started very early, 13 years old, in Rockledge, Florida. I'm a graduate of public schools here in Florida. Went to Cocoa High School. Spent 2 years as a Seminole and graduated from the University of Central Florida. From there, I went into the restaurant industry, spent 11 years with Red Lobster and Darden restaurants. How many people ever eaten in a Red Lobster? Seafood's pretty good, isn't it? I then went up to Boston and built a company called Pizzeria Uno from 15 restaurants to almost $400 million system. I kept getting better with the food. I then became CEO of Ruth Chris Steakhouse. And they say anybody can sell a $30 steak ought to belong in the United States Senate. But let me tell you who I really am. I'm just like you. I've spent my whole life on Main Street. We need more people in Washington that come from Main Street, not people that are career politicians and spent their whole life in Pennsylvania. Most people don't know or couldn't fathom the fact that current U.S. Senator Bill Nelson has been in political office for 40 years. 40 years. I've been in Main Street for 40 years. And I can tell you, I know more about the American people. I know what they like to eat. I know how to make them happy. I know what happens to them when they get under stress. I've borrowed money from banks and built restaurants. I've always paid it back. I understand how to put capital to work. I understand how jobs are created. I understand why jobs aren't getting created today. It's a lack of leadership, it's a lack of action on the part of our government. It's stifling our economy, hurting our ability to meet our obligations. It's the fact that we spend 40 cents more than we get in revenue. It's the fact that we have states that have to borrow money from the federal government to balance their budgets. We have to remind ourselves sometimes that governments seem to spend every penny we send them. We have to remind ourselves that not only at the federal level do they spend every penny we send them, they spend $1.40 for every dollar they get. That they borrow money to make Social Security payments. There's something wrong with our government, and I believe it's the people in the government that make it bad.
Yeah.
What I want to do for you and for my children and for my grandchildren is go to Washington and take my life's experiences. I talked to several people in the room tonight, and I can tell you when I ran for Congress last year and came up 1,600 votes, we sent Sandy Adams to the U.S. Congress. She's going to be a great congresswoman. I told her I'd never run against her. She's a good congressman. Congresswoman, she deserves to be there. When I look at this race, we need a different type of leader in Washington to replace Bill Nelson. I think I'm that person. I come from a relatively middle-class family. My dad was orphaned when he was 8. My mom came from a sharecropper family in South Carolina. He raised me to be self-reliant. You want something out of life, you go get it. You work hard, you grab a hold of that ladder, you pull yourself up, and you can be successful. I want to take that attitude and that knowledge and that set of life's experiences to Washington, and I and we can make a difference. It's not only the votes you cast in Washington when you're a United States Senator, it's what and how you can influence other senators in the U.S. Senate. If I can get 20 or 30 people to believe, because not because of what I say, or not because of what I read, but because of what I've done, we can make progress. We seem to operate our government from crisis to crisis. We create crises to justify some of the things we do. That's going on right now. When the President of the United States stands in front of the American people and threatens their Social Security checks and their Medicare check, it is a symptom of a bad government. I want to go to Washington and change that. And I think not only am I well qualified, I am passionate, I love my country. I went to Vietnam when I was 19 years old, volunteered to do that. I have been serving people all my life. But I haven't taken a government check in 35 years. I'm not going to Washington to represent you, the people of the state of Florida, because I need to. I'm going to Washington as your United States Senator to represent you. And if I only spend 6 years in Washington, that's okay with me, as long as I make the right decision for the people of Florida and the people of the United States. I met Joe a few months ago. I heard about Sarasota County. I heard about the power of the Sarasota Republican Party. And when Joe and I chatted yesterday, I launched my campaign on Tuesday. I talked to Joe on Wednesday, and I'm in Sarasota County tonight because the person that wins the Sarasota County United States Senate nomination will be the next United States Senator from the great state of Florida. Tonight that I swear I've known in my lifetime. I know how to connect with people because I've been in the people business all my life. I spent half of my time at the back door of my kitchen talking to my employees and the other half at the front door talking to my guests. The heart of a restaurant is its kitchen. The heart of the Republican Party in Florida is Sarasota County. I am proud to be here tonight. I appreciate your support. Look at all the candidates in this race. You will not find a lot of philosophical differences between the rest of the Republican candidates in this Florida, in this race. But you will find in Craig Miller is someone that's had a lifetime of experience serving the American people. I want to write a different menu for our government. Because as a restaurateur, we know that if you're not having a seat at the table, the chances are you might be on the menu, and that's not a good thing. Thank you very much.